This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to find the equation of a rational function when you're given its asymptotes and its zeros. So here's the first problem. Write an equation for a rational function with vertical asymptotes at x equals negative 2 and x equals 3, a horizontal asymptote at y equals 1, and zeros at 1, 0, and 4, 0. Okay, so let's call this function f of x. And I'm going to start out by using the vertical asymptotes to find the factors of the denominator. So I've got a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 2, which means that x plus 2 will be a factor of the denominator. And I've got a vertical asymptote at x equals 3, so x minus 3 will be a factor of the denominator. Then I'll go on and find out what the factors of the numerator will be. I'll get those by looking at the zeros. There's a 0 at 1, 0, so I'm going to have x minus 1 as a factor in the numerator, and there's a 0 at 4, 0, so I'll have x minus 4 as a factor in the numerator. Now let's take the numerator, take the binomials, and multiply those out, and we'll do the same thing for the denominator. So I'll have f of x equals, let's see, x times x is x squared. I've got a negative 4x and a negative 1x, so that's minus 5x. And negative 1 times negative 4 is positive 4. For the denominator, I've got x squared. 2x minus 3x is negative x. And 2 times negative 3 is negative 6. Okay, so the last step is to check and make sure that what I've got here will give me the appropriate horizontal asymptote. I want a horizontal asymptote at y equals 1. I've got two polynomials. They're both second degree, and they both have the same lead coefficient, which would be 1. So that means the horizontal asymptote is going to be at 1, at y equals 1, and that's what I'm looking for. So what I've got here is going to be the equation for the function that meets these requirements. Okay, let's look at one more. This says, write an equation for a rational function with vertical asymptotes at x equals 4 and x equals 7, a horizontal asymptote at y equals negative 2, and zeros at negative 3, 0, and 5, 0. So this is pretty much the same process. We'll call the function f of x. We'll find the factors for the denominator by looking at the vertical asymptotes. I've got a vertical asymptote at x equals 4, so that means I want x minus 4 in my denominator. And I've got a vertical asymptote at x equals 7, so I also want x minus 7 as a factor in the denominator. I'll take a look at the zeros and find out what the numerator should look like. I've got a 0 at negative 3, 0, so I'm going to want x plus 3. And I've got a 0 at 5, 0, so I'll want x minus 5. So those are the two factors of my numerator. We'll multiply the binomials in the numerator, the binomials in the denominator. That's going to give me f of x equals x squared. And then I've got a 3x and a negative 5x, so that's minus 2x. And 3 times negative 5 is negative 15. For the denominator, I'll have x squared. Negative 4x and negative 7x will give me minus 11x. And negative 4 times negative 7 is positive 28. Okay, let's check the horizontal asymptote. What I've got here will have a horizontal asymptote at y equals 1. since they're both second degree polynomials with the same lead coefficient. But I want y equals negative 2 as my horizontal asymptote. So I'm going to have to take that numerator, the whole polynomial, and multiply it by negative 2. So let's do that. I'm going to end up with f of x equals negative 2x squared, and then negative 2 times negative 2x will be plus 4x. Negative 2 times negative 15 is plus 30. The denominator is unchanged. That's still x squared minus 11x plus 28. Okay, so there's my answer to that problem. And that's really about all there is to it. Take care. I'll see you next time.